Hey guys, my name is Kelly from It's Just Kelly, and today I'm going to be doing a review of the Honeypot Cup for Put a Cup in It. So before we get into talking about the menstrual cup, I wanted to just give you guys a few details about the Honeypot company itself. Not only do they carry menstrual cups, but they also carry a wide range of menstrual products that are not only 100% natural, but they are also biodegradable and cruelty-free, which is always a plus. And they are black owned, which is amazing to be able to highlight that right now. And also, on top of that, they are affordable products, which is so important when it comes to something that you need as a necessity monthly. Moving on to the cup, which is what I'm reviewing today, it does come in a size 1 and a size 2. The size 1 says for women between ages of 19 to 30 with a medium flow, and for size 2 for women over 30 or post baby with a heavy flow. I've always said this before, I never pay attention to any of the recommendations on cup boxes ever, because I don't think that they are 100% accurate in regards to helping you find your exact cup. If you are having an issue finding your exact cup from recommendations, because again, I don't feel like they're super accurate, go ahead and go check out Put a Cup in It's quiz, which is online, which I will leave a link underneath this video as well, and it will help direct you to the right size cup and the right type of cup that might work best for you and your body. But I kind of disregard these recommendations because I actually, between the two of these cups, preferred the size 1 cup, which I am clearly over 30. I have had 3 children, and I have anywhere between a medium and a light flow at this point in my life. When it comes to the packaging of this cup, it's pretty standard. There's no extra glitzy anything to it. There is some plastic included in it with the window and everything and the tape at the top. I think the less packaging, the better, because when you're using a cup, you kind of want to minimize the waste in general. So you do get a little storage bag. This is just made out of, it seems like, a regular cotton linen-y material, and then you have a little pamphlet that has everything about the cup on it, and then your cup. When it comes to the size of the cup, I feel like they're pretty much the basic sizes that I've seen just in general. I do like that the size 2 cup, even though it is larger, it is more tapered at the bottom. So if you're somebody like me who can get away with using the size 1, this one still might be comfortable because it is tapered enough at the bottom, especially if you maybe cut off part of the stem. This one I would suggest using if you have a very high cervix, and that's kind of why I don't really say go by the recommendations on the box, because a lot of it has to do where your cervix is in your cycle or just how you're built. If you're like me and you have your cervix that kind of goes up and down throughout your cycle, mine starts really, really high and then lowers towards the end of my cycle, then sometimes you need to go between a size 1 and a 2. For this, in the beginning of my cycle, I definitely need to use a size 2, and I'll explain why in a little bit. And towards the end though, the size 1 is perfect for me. And to figure out if you have one of those traveling cervixes that like to go up and down, just stick your finger up there sometime and just feel around. It's basically like a little nubby thing that people say feels like the tip of your nose. I would agree with that, except for mine feels a little bit firmer than the tip of my nose, but if you move around in there and kind of explore your body, you'll kind of figure out what I'm talking about. But feel your way around during your cycle just to see where your cervix sits, and then that can actually be a really good key indicator if you need a taller or bigger cup versus a smaller cup. And I say that because smaller cups will tend to kind of suck right way up, and then it can be hard to get them down, versus having a larger cup that can sit higher up underneath your cervix, catch things more efficiently, and then also be easier to pull out when you're ready to empty your cup and put it back in. This cup has 4 air holes around the rim. It has the measuring inside of the cup instead of outside of the cup, so that it is smooth all the way around and you won't have to feel any abrasiveness on the outside of the cup in your vagina. It does have some grippers at the bottom of the stem and then also at the bottom of the cup itself, so that way you can grip it, pull it down. The stem is a tube style, which is a downfall for me. If I had to say anything negative so far with this cup, is that there is a tube stem. And the reason for this is because I have a hard time keeping those types of stems clean. I don't think there's any reason for them. I will actually show you. I don't know if you can see. The inside of my stem is actually dirty from when I last used it, even though I boiled it and cleaned it and tried to clean it out as best as possible. I could not get everything out. So now it's kind of like dried up in there. I'm gonna have to get some type of like squeegee or something to clean it it out. I don't like a hollow stem. I think it's a really easy place for bacteria to build, and it's hollow all the way to the edge of the bottom of the cup. In regards to the grippies on the stem, I don't find them effective. And even the grippies on the bottom of the cup were actually really slippery, especially when it was inside my vagina and the blood and discharge was making it even more slippery. It doesn't have a great grip. So that brings me back to why I prefer one size during the beginning of my cycle when my cervix is really high versus another later in my cycle when my cervix is low. I wore this on my first day, and even though it went in and it popped open really, really easily because it's got a really nice rim and it kind of suctioned up there, it migrated up throughout the day, and I had the hardest time out of most all of my cups when reviewing them trying to get it out. And that's because it was so high up that every single time I went to grab the stem, it was so slippery because the grippies weren't super effective, and because it was a hollow stem and it was more smushy, I could not get a good grip on it. And then even when I tried to get my fingers around the ridges on the bottom of the cup, I still couldn't get it down. So finally I had to dig my nails in, which luckily my nails were a little bit grown out. I had to dig my nails in, pinch it to pull it a little bit down, and then break the seal and then wiggle it down. Now let's go into the positives of this cup, because I do really, really love this cup. It was so easy to put in. I did my usual punch down fold, put it in, and it popped open super easy. It also suctioned really, really well. Almost too well, like I said. It suctioned its way up there when my cervix was super high on the first day, and I struggled to bring it down because it just wanted to stay up there. That's a positive because, again, it stayed up the entire day when I was active and working around outside and, you know, being on my feet. Normally, towards the end of a 6-hour period, cups will kind of start, you know, coming down a little bit, kind of reminding me like, hey man, I'm still up here, you need to empty me and reinsert me, which is a good thing, but sometimes it's really annoying when you're not near a toilet and you don't want to deal with it. So that was a plus, having this suction so well that it stayed up there and didn't bother me at all. It also suctioned so well that every single time I went swimming with this cup in, I didn't have a single amount of leaking. I didn't have a single amount of chlorinated water in my cup when I went to pull it out. I used it 3 days in a row, 3 days swimming, hours on end. You guys know how my kids are right now. We're in the pool all the time. And it was the best swimming cup. In regards to comfort, I could not feel this cup the second I put it in, even with that stem on there. I used to cut off all my stems. Now I leave them on unless they're really annoying. I haven't had to do that in a long time with cups because most of the cups I've reviewed lately have been super, super comfortable. This one is also really, really comfortable. It is a really great cup. So if you can get past the fact that it's got a slippery stem, a slippery base, and work, you know, work with that and make sure to not get overly frustrated when trying to get it out, then you'll really love this cup. In regards to leaking while I had it on, it didn't leak in the pool, like I said, and I didn't have a single dang leak in my period underwear for the time that I was using it. My period was about 3 days solid with a little bit of discharge and a little bit of spotting towards my fourth day, and then it was completely done. I didn't have any cramping, completely short and sweet period in my book in regards to what my history has been. It's a good cup. Now, if you'd like to compare the size and the firmness of this cup with other cups, I will leave a link underneath this video to put a cup in its comparison chart where you can compare it to a bunch of other cups that are out right now to see kind of where it falls in line with other cups if you're already a cup owner. And then they also have a Facebook support group for people who have questions about cups or reusable products and all things menstrual products as well. So there you have it. There is my straightforward review and opinions of the Honey Pot cup. Like I mentioned, go ahead and take the period cup quiz on Put a Cup in its website if you'd like to see what cup best fits you. And then also check out the Honey Pot cup on their comparison chart if you're trying to see where it kind of falls in line with other brands. I hope you guys enjoyed this review of the Honey Pot cup with Put a Cup in It, and I will see you guys all in my next video. Bye.